Guys, we have got so much new info to talk about today. Some crazy updates released. And one of the coolest things is the Wonder Woman boss. Now, before we get into it, guys, if you think it would be awesome to hop onto Fortnite today and see that you've unlocked the Galaxy skin, wouldn't that be cool? If so, leave a thumbs up on the video, but be quick. But yes, guys, we've got a ton of different things to go over. We're gonna, of course, cover the new bosses and the new NPCs, but we're also gonna be going over some fun stuff like glitches, things with Season 8. It's gonna be a mix of everything. Now, as for the challenge with the comments on last video, the skin was Harley Quinn. So I left hearts on a bunch of the ones that got that right. And this time around, I say we go with this skin right here. So leave a comment if you know the name of it, and I will leave hearts on a bunch of the comments that get that right. Also, be sure to use code SIRS in the item shop. That helps out a bunch. And while you're at it, hit that subscribe button as well. But without further ado, let's go ahead and jump on into it. Now, first things first, guys, let's start off the video with something pretty fun. This is something I'm pretty sure you have never seen before, but it is a really cool thing to do. So basically, if we hop into Party Royale, I'm gonna show you guys a secret area. Now, first things first, we need to grab a couple of items. One is a crash pad and another is a grappler. And then on top of that, we need a quad crasher. Oh, and this guy's just sitting on a bench. Nice. So here we go, got some crash pads. So we're going to pick up a couple of those. Probably 3 or 4 is good. I'm so excited to give this a try. It's so cool. Then we'll grab our grappler and finally grab a quad crasher. Now that we have all of that stuff, we're ready to go. So we got to drive back into the center of town and then place the quad crasher in a specific spot right over in this area near the battle bus. We want to place it along. Wait a second, somebody already did it? They got rid of the stairs, which allows us to go underneath. Oh my gosh, guys, check that out. We are underneath the Party Royale map. That's so funny that somebody else already did it, and the grass is looking really weird. What is going on? Pretty sure it's not supposed to look like that, but this area is like huge. We can go so far around. Like, what about this big area here? Oh my goodness, we could have like a party down in this spot. Yeah, let's go. Oh man, too bad we can't get into that area. There's a huge area under the very center. But yeah, I still wanted to show you how this is actually done. What in the world? What the? That's so weird. Why are all the arrows like flying? I have never seen this before. All the players are just standing here. Did they just spawn in? Is this like a brand new lobby? Anyways, yeah, I wanted to show you guys that next step. Oh, and that's weird. We got a golden quad crasher now. Okay. Lots of weird things are happening today. But yeah, if we place the quad crasher in like about this area right here and then switch to the back seat. Actually, I think it needs to go forward just a tad. Let's try that. If we place it right there and then place a crash pad on top of it. Nope, we messed up. Needs to go to about the second step down, or would that be the third step? I don't know. But if we place the crash pad right, just like so, and then what is it? Exit? Oh my gosh, yeah, we got it. For some reason, it breaks the staircase beneath it, which allows us to get back into the secret area, or, you know, place a crash pad there. Either way, it's a really fun secret. Now, guys, let's start to talk a bit about the brand new NPCs and bosses that are coming into Fortnite. Now, before we talk about the Wonder Woman boss, because we have a lot of details about that, something else that has to do with NPCs first that I find super interesting is that according to Hypex, there's an upcoming unmasked version of the IO guards, probably for next season. Now, that is super intriguing because, well, it implies that the IO is going to be a part of Season 8, and the IO guards are going to make a return, but they're going to be different. Now, how different, we don't exactly know, but considering that they are the main type of NPC this time around, especially at Corny Complex and stuff like that, it would make sense that we see them again next season. Now, personally, what I'm really hoping happens is that they return as a sort of henchman. Granted, they kind of are at Corny Complex, but if you remember, what was it, Season 2 or 3, where we had the bosses and the henchmen guarding the vaults, that was so much fun, and I'm not sure why they don't bring it back this time around. The vaults were such an amazing thing, I would love to see them return. But next up, guys, before we talk about the brand new boss, I want to show you something that's really important with the story that has actually been revealed through the quests. So if we click on here, this one, we got another one from Dr. Sloan. Get Sloan's orders from a payphone. Now, that's obviously not the thing. There's a quest after that that reveals some crazy things. Like, you gotta see this. So here we go, answering the payphone to get Sloan's orders. I cannot read it behind the storm forming thing, but good thing that's not really that important. Oh, somebody's shooting at me. You can't get me, buddy. Nope, none of that. And he ran away. Told ya. All right, so one of the other quests apparently is to hit these dummies with a IO weapon, which I got Dr. Sloan's. But this isn't where the story actually gets interesting. So let's finish off this quest. There we go, got it. And now we can hop into the next one. There we go, guys. Finally, after completing pretty much every other challenge, we got the one that's interesting. Collect alien devices, then activate the countermeasure device underneath Corny Complex. Oh my gosh, this took so long. So yeah, apparently we got to go to each of these locations to actually grab some of the alien devices. And you might be wondering what those are, but check this out. So first up, we got to go okay, I messed up the map. Nice. We got to go down to close to the center to find the first alien device. Now let's keep an eye out. Where exactly is this alien device? Oh, there it is right there. I found it. This other guy's going to it as well. Oh, cool. Yeah, look at that. It's less of a device and more of just an orb. But oh my gosh, guys, take a closer look at that. It has the same exact texture as Kevin the Cube. Oh, and it's completely dark inside. That's interesting as well, but it's got the same symbols and everything. Why are they using these alien devices? Is that the first confirmation that the aliens are connected to Kevin the Cube? Again, we've been talking so much about how season 8 is going to have Kevin involved in some way, but that is an extra bit of confirmation that again, the aliens are involved with the cube as well. So let's keep going here because we also got to figure out what the device inside of Corny Complex is for. So quick grab the device before I get eliminated by this dude. No, leave me alone. Oh, he's running away and now I'm running away. And then there's this person. Can we dodge them? How did we survive that? No way. Oh my gosh. Yep, I have no mats. There's nothing I can do. Nothing. Although, you know what's weird about this? Kevin is a cube and this is a sphere. What is happening in Fortnite? Crazy things are going down. But there we go. We finally got all of the devices. Now we can head to the main area of Corny Complex to see what this whole device thing is all about. So don't mind us just plowing through here. What's up, everybody? I'm being super sneaky. So I'm going to go down into this area. Oh, that's the boss. I did not want to go down into that area. Change of plans. Oh, that's an enemy as well. All right, this is definitely not going according to plan. Let's go down this way instead. There we go. We found the device. So I'm just going to install the parts right away. And there we go. The device is on. Oh my goodness, check out that animation. That was wild. Yo, the device just went all the way down into the ground. And what did that text say? Oh man, I'm curious to see what Dr. Sloan told us about what just happened. But yeah, we put the whole bomb type thing in preparation for next week. So what is going to happen? There's definitely going to be some crazy stuff going down. And guys, real quick, I went back to see what Dr. Sloan said, and she says they won't suspect a thing until we strike. So this is definitely for the event that is happening soon. This stuff is gonna be awesome. But the main boss and everything that I wanted to talk about today is the Wonder Woman boss. As you guys know, Wonder Woman recently released as a skin in the item shop. And I think there was even a tournament for the Wonder Woman skin as well, which is just the beginning of her becoming a boss in the game. Now again, going back to what Hypex had said, he had also said there's an unreleased flying NPC. Now so far, nobody really knows what exactly that could be, but let's think for a second. What recently released skin has the ability to fly? I mean, take a look at the item shop again. You can see Wonder Woman literally flying with wings in the featured image for that skin. I mean, who else could be the flying NPC besides Wonder Woman? It makes so much sense. It is perfect. And on top of that, take a look at a bunch of the skins that recently became bosses and NPCs on the map. We recently got Superman, Armored Batman, and of course, Beast Boy, all of which I'm pretty sure are from DC. Beast Boy's from the DC universe, right? I think so. But for sure, Superman and Batman, they all became NPCs. So Wonder Woman also has to become an NPC soon. Now, as for the location that I think she would show up at, honestly, it could be anywhere around the map, considering that Superman showed up in, what was it, that farm area north of Corny Complex? That didn't even really make sense. But still, I think a good spot for Wonder Woman to be a boss at is this section right here. there. The one to the north of Misty Meadows. I don't believe there's a boss there right now, but I think she'd be the type of NPC to sort of stick to herself, and that's a very quiet place that would make a lot of sense. But then we also gotta ask the question, would she drop a mythic weapon? Honestly, at this point in the season, I don't think so, considering that, again, Superman, Beast Boy, and what's his name? Armored Batman, of course. They don't have any special mythic weapon, so if she is added in this season, I don't think she'll have any special weapon, but if instead she is added in season 8, it's entirely possible that we could see some sort of unique mythic ability. I mean, I'm still hoping that they bring back the type of mythic abilities that we saw during the Marvel season. That was so much fun, and Wonder Woman could have some really cool abilities, like, well, the ability to fly. She's literally a flying NPC, but also that whip, that would make a super cool ability as well. Even if it's used as like just a grappler, that would be so cool. But yeah, again, the season's almost coming to an end, so I don't know if they'd add her quite yet, but could that mean that we see a lot more DC characters next season? I mean, this one was definitely DC themed with Superman being in the battle pass and all, so maybe next season has even more of a DC theme. That would be so cool. But anyways, guys, that is gonna be it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, remember to subscribe and turn on notifications for more fun videos like this coming up super soon. On top of that, you can check out some of my previous videos on the screen right now, such as going over a ton of new season 8 info. But again, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you in the next one.